Just the other day, I was trying to explain why brushless motor control design is such a hot topic in the world of electronic engineering today. Mind you, this person is not an engineer. So, all of those new power tools you were looking at buying? Brushless motor control designs. Yep. Oh, why is that so cool? And then I went into this long diatribe about MOSFETs, gate drivers, LDOs, and the like, and their eyes kind of rolled back in their head, and I knew I'd lost them. Thank goodness you guys understand what I'm talking about. Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. What I didn't mention to my friend the other day is that brushless motor control design is becoming a bigger and bigger deal in industrial applications as well. In today's Chalk Talk, CJ Waters from onsemi and I are talking about how the demands of Industry 4.0 are encouraging innovation in the realm of brushless motor control design. We take a closer look at the various components involved in this kind of design, and even how collaborative robots take advantage of the benefits of BLDCs. Maybe I should make that friend of mine watch this video, huh? And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about this topic from onsemi. Hi, CJ. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure.
Okay, CJ, so we're talking about brushless motors today. But before we get started, can you set the stage for us? What kind of components are we really talking about here?
Yeah, brushless motors are quickly taking over the industrial market, whether it's power tools and robotics to e-bikes and scooters. There's a lot of different applications that brushless motors are appearing in. And when it comes to these brushless motor applications, onsemi has a lot of different solutions offered for this application. So whether it's our MOSFETs, our isolation devices, I mean, all of the products shown in those green boxes on the screen, those are solutions offered by onsemi. So we do a great job at covering the brushless motor applications.
CJ, I've heard about onsemi in this realm before, but why do you think you guys are best suited for this kind of design?
Yeah, onsemi really has decades of experience working with customers in the industrial BLDC market. And on top of that, we have a lot of market leadership for the products that go into those applications, as well as a lot of different support systems and tools that customers can use through our website. In this picture, you can see that there's a full motor drive completely integrated inside the joint of cobots. That's shown on the left there. That's kind of a cobot arm. So in that application, high power density is critical, but we also need a lot of power to be generated. So the most common solution in those is our discrete MOSFETs, where we're looking for a low RDS on in a compact package. So on it has a lot of different packages and MOSFET options, and we have a lot of solutions to be offered in that market for the cobot arms and all different brushless DC applications. So again, in that picture, you can see kind of a block diagram of the cobot application, as well as down below, you can see all the different products that ON has to offer for that application. So our BLDC controllers, gate drivers, MOSFETs, eFuse, current sense. We offer all those solutions. We have great portfolios within each of those solutions. So ON has a lot of coverage for that application. And as I mentioned before, a lot of expertise, a lot of support for that application.
Okay, so CJ, when it comes to BLDCs, what do you think they really buy me as an engineer?
Yeah, so the most common option besides BLDC is the brush DC. So when you're comparing those, brushless is going to end up being higher cost, but the performance benefits much outweigh the cost of it. So, you know, brushless is going to be more efficient due to its design, and it's able to run cooler and therefore convert more electricity into power. It's also going to be lighter weight while still having a compact size, but also having equal or better power than the brushed motors. So as you get these lighter, for example, power tools, when they're lighter and smaller in size and still have the same amount of power, if not more, that's obviously a great benefit for anyone using it. The brushless also has more speed under load, which makes it even faster than the brushed options. And then to top it all off, brushless has a longer lifespan than the brushed motors. So brushless is a great option. And when we're looking at this option, On has a lot of different products to offer, as I've mentioned. So you can see that we have our T6 series low voltage and medium voltage MOSFETs. We have a wide voltage range for those, as well as current sense amplifiers, wide VN LDOs. We have our E-fuses, which are a great solution, as well as gate drivers. And as I mentioned, a lot of different tools, whether it's evaluation boards or online tools through our website that can be used for any designers of these brushless applications.
Okay, so CJ, can we look at some real life BLDC applications?
Yeah, so as I mentioned before, there's so many different brushless DC applications, whether it's power tools and cobots, or here you can see kind of an overview of the e-bike market. So when looking at this market from 2020 to 2027, there's an estimated CAGR of about 7 to 11%. The pandemic has actually accelerated growth for that market, which is a great upside for everyone involved. And looking at that market, China and Europe are the fastest growing regions. And you can see our e-bike sales in general are about 50% of all bikes by 2030 are going to be in Europe. So when looking at this application, most of them are limited to 750 watts. And On has a lot of great options. We have our discrete FETs that go into these e-bike applications. We also have our e-fuse and other protection devices, which are really improving the performance and size of these e-bikes, as well as our current sense amplifiers, which really help boost the performance of those applications.
Okay, cool. So CJ, can we look a little closer at the motor drive in particular here?
Yeah, this slide gives a great look at the up close of the motor drive and kind of how it works. Coming out of the battery, we have our battery MOSFETs around the battery system. And then we move into our voltage regulation, where an E-fuse is commonly used. E-fuses are a great alternative now, a new option for that, because they offer a lot of different benefits in one small package that's all combined together. I'll touch on that later. But yeah, E-fuses are a great option for that. And then we move through the power stage, where, again, we have a lot of MOSFET options to be used there, as well as our DC to DC, or LDO, the regulation there. And then we get into our gate drivers and our current control, or our current sense amplifiers, as I've mentioned, which give a good solid performance and improve its efficiency. So all these blocks in green shown are solutions offered by On Semiconductor.
Cool. Okay. So do you have any other applications you can talk about?
Yeah. So we can get into a look at the collaborative robots or cobots overview. Kind of go into the market trends here. So robots are becoming more and more important in industrial applications. And they're actually, not only are we going to automated robots, but we have robots that work side by side with people in control. So that's the collaborative robots. We're seeing a rise in those. And as we analyze that market more, we're seeing that cobots have a great return on investment in the long run. And they're compact and flexible and easy to work with, and just really improve efficiency of these industrial markets. So again, looking at that market, the CAGR is about 40% estimated from 2019 to 2026. Once again, similar to the e-bikes, Europe is the largest segment. And then looking at kind of the facts about the market, there's a 5 kilogram payload that dominates the market. And then again, going into On Semiconductor solutions that are offered, we have power modules, which I will touch on later as well, which are just integrated modules that have all the components combined for power driving, as well as our individual discrete MOSFETs, and again, our E-fuse and current sense options.
Okay, so can we get into some of the motor drive details of these collaborative robots?
Yeah, again, this is a great look. We're going to look at a block diagram of the collaborative robot. This kind of gives an up-close view. So coming in from the grid, we have our power, and that's going to be, as that enters the system, we need some sort of protection device there. So looking at this high-level block diagram, except for the controller in gray, On Semiconductor offers all the products in green. So whether it's for the power, the protection, or the sensing stages, we offer all those solutions. Some of the key products covered by our power solutions group are the power modules, the MOSFETs, eFuse in protection, current sense amplifiers, or our LDOs, again, which is shown in all green. So we are offering solutions for all of those, which is great to be able to offer the best efficiency we can in these applications.
Okay, so CJ, can we dig in a little deeper into the three different components? What about your MOSFET solutions? What kind of benefits do they bring to the table?
This slide shows a great overall view of the MOSFETs that onsemi has to offer. So this is specifically our medium voltage MOSFETs. So ON has two lines of technologies for the medium voltage MOSFETs. On the bottom, you can see our T families, whether it's T6, T8, or our T10. That's in development. That will be offered either as a T10 or a T10M. Those are in development, and those are great options in the medium voltage market. And that's commonly from 25 to 80 volts for those T families. And then on the top, you can see the PTNG, or power trench next generation technology. And that's more in the little bit higher range of voltage for 80 to 150 volts. So for our medium voltage up to 80 volts, we have our T6 FETs, which are going to be optimized for low resistance like motor drive. And then as we transition into the newer version T8, these devices are going to be more optimized for switching performance. And those are used in faster switching applications like DC-DC converters. And then the next generation coming after that is our T10. Like I said, it will come as either standard T10 or the T10M. The T10M is going to be more optimized for low RDS on, like motor applications. That'll be a great market for that. And then with that option, we expect it to have a 35% reduction in gate charge and output charge. Again, as I mentioned, we have our T6 technology that has a very low RDS on. But when it comes to looking at how does it achieve this feature, this is mainly thanks to our shielded gate concept. And you can see a closer look at that in the image on the left. So compared to a traditional trench concept, the shielded gate concept helps to reduce the RDS on in the epi layer of the MOSFET structure. And this is responsible for a big portion of the total RDS on. So all this is possible without a penalty in the gate charge. And this technique helps to reduce the area that supports the blocking voltage, which therefore allows that technology to achieve a lower RDS on, but while maintaining the same blocking voltage capability. So all this combines to help achieve an excellent RDS on and gate charge figure of merit.
Okay, cool. So CJ, what about gate drivers?
Yeah, so ON has a lot of different gate driver technologies as well, and a lot of different options for that. So when we get into looking at our gate drivers, first, starting from left, we have our non-isolated gate drivers. And seen in the green is some of our main part numbers within this category. So a lot of applications that we're seeing that in is our HVAC, power factor correction, our uninterruptible power supplies, motor control. And these options are going to be great because they have the high drive current while also having a low propagation delay, and then offering other features such as DSAT, clamping, UVLO, TSD, etc. And then moving into our high side and low side gate drivers, again, you can see the part numbers that we have to offer. And these are more commonly seen in intelligent power modules or motor control and white goods, such as all the different applications that we see in our home. Again, this is also going to offer the high drive current and a low propagation delay, but it's also added dead time control in there. And then moving into our internally isolated gate drivers, we have some main product numbers seen there. The NCD57000 is one of our most common product numbers for that. So our internally isolated gate drivers are seen in a lot more applications in our uninterruptible power supply, our solar inverters, motor control, and EV chargers. Or we can get more into the automotive-focused traction inverters and onboard charging. And again, with the highlight features of these are it's going to have that high drive current and the low propagation delay, while also offering all the full features seen, as well as better isolation certification, which is needed in certain applications. This gives a good look at the brushless DC gate drivers that we have to offer and kind of the performance that goes along with that. So when we're looking at the efficiency, you're looking at 10% power on reduction, 17% power off reduction, And then when we look at our reliability, again, we have all those features that I mentioned in the slide before with our DSAT, our Miller clamp, under voltage and low voltage protection. When we look at our cost and convenience of those gate drivers, since we have such a wide portfolio, we're able to offer a lot lower cost solutions with the non-isolated drivers family. And even though that doesn't have as good a performance, for a lot of applications, when cost is of importance, that's a great option outside of the better performing isolated gate drivers.
So CJ, LDOs are also another component we need to look at, right? What does onsemi offer here?
onsemi offers a very wide portfolio of LDOs with a lot of best-in-class trade-offs, whether you're looking for low noise or high PSRR, or the voltage drop, or even your voltage range for your input. So when we look at our high-performance LDOs, we feature the ultra-low noise, high PSRR, and that's going to be a great option when you're looking to improve the image quality. By lowering that ultra-low noise, we're able to really have a lot less interference and improve that image quality. And then moving into our ultra-low IQ for our quiescent current, we can actually get that down to a microamp of quiescent current, which is really going to drastically reduce the power consumption, which in turn leads to the longer battery life. So the less leakage you have from that battery through that quiescent current, the longer your battery is going to last and the better performance you're going to have. So that's really a great high-performance option there. And as we keep developing more products in the industrial application, we're going to keep developing products for the wide VN option. We'll have more options in that family to fit all the different applications in the industrial market.
Okay, so we should also talk about e-fuses, which we've talked about quite a lot here on Chalk Talk. But for my audience who may not know, what do onsemi e-fuses buy me in this context?
These e-fuses offered by onsemi are kind of a great one-stop shop for a product that offers a lot of different features in a small package. So with having the smaller package, you're actually able to reduce the board size in your application while also not having to compromise the performance of it. So you can see in that top left picture, our main highlights with the eFuse are we have overvoltage, thermal, and overcurrent protection all integrated into one device. So what had been done previously in different devices, we've integrated into one device. And then on top of that, we have a lot of features as well, such as current monitoring, fault and enable options, you know, power good options, short to battery protection. So these e-fuses are really a great option to have, like I said, a kind of a one-stop shop. It's one smaller package, but it offers a lot of different features. So you were seeing a rise in the market as all these different applications push for smaller board sizes and such.
Okay, so amplifiers also play an important role in these kinds of systems, right?
Yeah, looking at onsemi amplifiers, we have our different operational amplifier portfolio. And looking from left to right, we have, you know, our general purpose amplifiers, which are going to be our lower cost commodity solutions. And then we get into our low power amplifiers. And then we move up to our precision amplifiers and our current sense amplifiers, and then finally our instrumentation amplifiers. So as we move from left to right, you're going to increase the performance and cost of the amplifiers that onsemi has to offer. And looking directly at the current sense amplifiers, these are really a great option for BLDC because they integrate external resistors to monitor the current consumption in the system. The BLDC systems require a lot of high accuracy and efficiency. And in our amplifier portfolio, we offer products that have both precision and low power performance. So when looking at BLDC specifically, the current sense amplifiers are used for both high side and low side current sensing, which offers enhanced transient response and sensing range. As I mentioned, we have a very wide family of amplifier options. We have been known previously as a commodity operational amplifier supplier, but over the past few years, we've really done a lot of development to improve the performance of our amplifiers. And now you can see our very wide range of performance amplifiers that we have to offer.
Okay, great. So isolation can also be crucial in BLDC design. What does onsemi offer in this arena?
Yeah, on semiconductor, we still offer your typical optocouplers that have been seen in all the years past. It's kind of an older technology, but we do still have options for that. And then we've moved into the on-chip magnetic and capacitive isolation. So you can see that the speed improves when comparing it to our optocouplers, as well as certain other benefits shown in that table. But the main highlight when we're talking about isolation is our off-chip capacitive isolation. And that's actually patented by onsemiconductor. That's going to be our Digimax technology. And when looking at the off-chip capacitor isolation, that technology is designed to achieve very high insulation and high noise immunity. And this is characterized by high common mode rejection and power supply rejection specs. So the distance through isolation, or DTI, is actually going to end up being 10 times that of the on-chip capacitive device, which is a huge improvement. When you're looking at the performance, this difference results in a lot of performance benefits of the optocouplers. It's going to kind of have similar performance, but it exceeds that when you're looking at speed and the overall lifetime performance of that device. It's going to end up lasting a lot longer than optocouplers are able to, while also performing a lot better.
Okay, so finally, CJ, we should also take a closer look at your power modules. So what kind of benefits does onsemiconductor bring to power modules in particular?
Yeah, on top of all the other great options that onsemiconductor offers when looking at this application, another great technology is our power modules. And those power modules are meant to maximize the power delivery while reducing the footprint or size when external control and gate drive are required. So what we're doing with these is we're taking all of the components that are normally sold as discretes in the system, and we're actually integrating it into one module, you know, optimize the best performance possible while also having it in one package, which, you know, allows us to reduce the footprint. When looking at these power modules, ON actually manufactures the wafer and packaging in-house from start to finish. And then we combine them into an elegant finish solution, which is optimized for the best performance. For options for these power modules, we have either full silicon power modules, or we have hybrid with silicon and silicon carbide. And then as we move through that into the better performance, we have full silicon carbide modules. That's seen in the highlight product. Our full silicon carbide modules are going to give the best performance and the best reliability while also reducing that footprint. So all our power modules are designed to reduce the cooling effort, and they also have patented termination structure, which allows those devices to have a lot superior robustness.
Excellent. Okay, CJ. Well, I think that's all I have time for today. Thank you so much for joining me.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. I appreciate your time. You know, onsemiconductor is always here to help customers, so we appreciate it.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about this topic from onsemiconductor. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talks section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/eejournal.